Swipe to the left to bring up the controls. Select the face tracking mode. The focus indicator will turn blue. The camera is now locked onto my face. This is our first look at Blackmagic Design's first phase detect autofocus camera. No, this isn't a new camera. This feature is being brought to the Cinema Camera 6K through a free firmware update. You won't have this feature on your camera unless you specifically upgrade your firmware. And of course, you will need an electronic lens that has internal focus motors. I'm using Panasonic's 24-105mm f4 and their 70-200 f4. This feature is currently in beta. That means its function and appearance will change. Check the details in the video's description to find out how you can download and try the firmware yourself. The new firmware will be installed on your camera using the Blackmagic Camera Setup utility. Once installed, head to Settings. On the second setup page, you will find the autofocus type options. Select PDAF. Once this mode is enabled, swiping left from the right-hand side of the screen allows you to choose your autofocus mode. Here's a brief description of how each mode works. Autofocus single. This is the simplest mode. On a photography camera, this would be called one-shot autofocus. Just tap anywhere on the screen to focus. Alternatively, you can use the physical focus button on the back of the camera. If you've already specified a focus point, it will refocus on that. If you double tap the focus button, it will recenter your focusing point to the center of the screen and then focus. Autofocus continuous. It works the same as autofocus single, but with one key difference, it will continually focus until disengaged. On stills cameras, this mode is sometimes called servo. Object tracking. In this mode, the camera will track an object and attempt to keep it in focus. Choose which object to track simply by tapping on the touchscreen. It maintains a lot using a combination of AI object and pattern recognition. Face tracking. Finally, in this mode, the camera will track faces in the frame. It can track up to three faces. Choose a face by tapping. In a future firmware update, it will be possible to assign a custom function button to switch between faces. In the tracking modes, colors are used to indicate status. Blue indicates the object is being tracked and is in focus. Yellow indicates that the camera is hunting for focus. Red indicates the track has failed or the camera has lost focus. This is not a review. This is a technology demonstration. This feature is in beta. It's not a finished product. So it's only fair to reserve any final judgment till the final version is released. But I think what we can do is speculatively manage expectations. This is Blackmagic's first generation of phase detection autofocus. Once finished, we don't expect this to be better than your FX3 or your S5 2X or your C70. That's because autofocus is hard and companies like Sony and Canon have a head start. They have been iterating their autofocus system for decades. The more relevant question to ask is it good enough and how close is it? Well, here's three quick scenarios. Scenario one, keeping a talking head in focus. With manual focus, I'd need to land my mark precisely. With face tracking autofocus, I have the freedom not just to sway back and forth, but even to walk off my spot. Scenario two, pulling focus in AFS mode works great. Instead of having to zoom in to check critical focus, I can confidently use the touchscreen to focus, or my preference is to use the focus button on the back of the camera. Scenario three, it's very capable of tracking distinct objects. These features are still in beta, so we expect their stickiness and stability to improve with time. But in their present condition, they already can have a positive impact on production. Being able to handle a wider variety of objects and more extreme changes in position and angle will benefit the autofocus on this camera. We're also looking forward to seeing intelligent modes where the camera is able to select the correct focusing mode as faces and objects enter frame. Are you looking to master DaVinci Resolve? All of these brand new version 20 features are incredible, but to work effectively in Resolve, you need a comprehensive understanding of Resolve's core features. That's what our course, DaVinci Resolve for Editors, is designed to do. It features over 10 hours of training, spread over 52 lessons, and it comes with 2 entire hours of incredible practice material that we shot specifically for you to use. We're running an NAB 2025 special discount. There's details in the description. We look forward to seeing you on the course. Why is this significant? A new feature has been added to your camera, and it didn't cost you anything. It would have been easy for Blackmagic to release autofocus in a brand new camera, devaluing your existing investment and forcing additional expenditure. Now, of course, this was only possible because the CC6K has a sensor that already had PDAF sensors. But think about that for a moment, because the Pixis 6K has the same sensor. We're hoping that we're going to see autofocus rolled out to the Pixis 2. We also think that we will see further updates within reason for existing products with the required hardware. That means that the 6K and Pixis are still very worthwhile cameras to purchase. The same amazing price, but now even more features. Creating the first version of something is hard. In comparison, iteration and improvement is relatively easy. We've seen that pattern play out in other manufacturers' autofocus journeys. Now that this is out there, it seems reasonable to conclude that we will see continuous improvement from Blackmagic, whether through new firmware updates or new hardware releases. This is a sign of the future. Autofocus was perhaps the most significant missing feature from Blackmagic's cameras. Blackmagic has heard and answered. We're hoping this technology will mature to the point where autofocus is no longer a conversation when choosing which brand you will invest in. We hope you enjoyed this first look at this brand new beta firmware. We cannot wait for you to try it out yourselves. There will be details in the description on how you can get hold of this firmware. In the meantime, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos like this. And thank you for watching.